I wrestled John Cena, and I went in, and I think it was 2013. I went in WWE champion, and we went in MetLife Stadium. We had a record-breaking attendance, which was amazing that night. We accomplished our goal.
Whether you're a fan of Rock the Dwayne Johnson from his wrestling days or on the big screen, you cannot deny the fact that this man had an incredible journey, and I think it's just the beginning. Struggles throughout his childhood till the later part of his life led him to the success he has right now. From moving around a ton to getting evicted at 15 years of age, the man has seen it all, and I guess that's what made him stronger, which eventually helped him to create such a massive empire for himself. After achieving so much so early, the man has not forgotten his roots. He is still one of the most humble celebrities in Hollywood. He has not let the fame impact his integrity and his values. Dwayne Johnson has been a huge inspiration to millions of people out there, and to do justice to his electrifying personality, we have his transformation segregated into different parts, and the initial days will be discussed by none other than a friend of mine, Vedant Kaushik, popularly known as Vedantrusty.
Hey everyone, welcome to Teenage Days, and thank you Sojesh for having me on your channel. My name is Vedantrusty. For those of you who do not know me, I make video essays, I make a lot of interesting analytical stuff. I'm really thankful to Sojesh for having me on this channel. Today we are talking about Dwayne Johnson, who honestly is one of my favorite WWE stars, one of my favorite action stars. And his story is very interesting because growing up, Dwayne Johnson moved around consistently. He remembers moving to New Zealand, Pennsylvania, Texas, a lot of other places. And one particular instance is that when he was 15, he came home to an eviction notice on his house in Honolulu because his mother could not afford the rent. This jarring moment from his childhood, I think, was one of the instances where he realized that he has to break out of the cycle of poverty and aspire to achieve and work in a career that would make him incredibly successful. Every day, people all around the world, different ages, different genders, different sizes, physiques, localities, are bullied. And even though it now looks very difficult to even wonder, but Dwayne Johnson was also bullied in his childhood. While he admitted to becoming a delinquent in 9th grade by doing stupid stuff, I think Dwayne Johnson also managed to put all these painful struggles behind him, and he aspired to work hard, and which is why he has a bachelor's degree in his education, which is an incredible thing considering the struggles that he's coming from in his life. Dwayne Johnson is the recipient of a scholarship, a full-time scholarship from the University of Miami, where he played as a defensive tackle, but a sideline injury kind of ruined his career in football. Because of his injury, he was replaced by Warren Sapp, who himself went on to become a huge NFL star. But Dwayne Johnson, in 1995, graduated with a bachelor's degree in general studies with concentrations in criminology and psychology. When the Calgary Stampeders cut him off, Dwayne Johnson flew back to Miami and he realized that he had only $7 to his name. He went on to explain that while he was happy with Sapp, the person who replaced him, and they still remain good friends to this day. I think this was one incident which makes him always go back to the fact that $7, all that he had to his name, was such an incredible lesson in the value of money. Dwayne Johnson worked really hard after that to find his success, and also battled depression after finding success. He went on to launch a production company called 7 Bucks Production, and now you know the meaning and the importance behind the name, which has a lot of meaning for Dwayne Johnson himself. And once his career in football was over, Dwayne Johnson turned to wrestling. And surprisingly, both sides of his family have strong roots in wrestling. His father, Soulman Rocky Johnson, was at the peak of his fame in the 70s and 80s. And he was part of the first black tag team with Tony Atlas in the 70s and 80s. And he won the first WWF, which is now WWE, tag team championship all the way back then. Johnson's maternal grandfather, High Chief Peter Maivia, who was a blood brother to the Anoa'i wrestling family, born in Samoa, relocated to New Zealand and started a wrestling career there. And Dwayne Johnson himself first emerged as Rocky Maivia. He debuted WWE in 1996 and then he became the biggest wrestling sensation that the world had ever seen. His charisma, his style made audiences worldwide go crazy when The Rock was on the stage. Can you smell what The Rock is cooking? His characteristic eyebrow raise, all these things made him my and a lot of other people's favorite wrestling superstar. And I think now I'll hand it back to Sojesh for taking the video further ahead. And again, thank you so much for having me in this video.
In 2001, Rock was finally spotted in Mummy Returns, and it was so well received and loved by audiences that the studio decided to make him start the prequel, The Scorpion King, the following year. Recognizing his bankability, the studio paid him $5.5 million, which was a record for an actor in his first lead. Since then, he starred in many movies, and in no time, he became the sensation what he is today. Dwayne Johnson is not a man who takes his career lightly. He makes sure that he knows what his audiences expect from him. And to maintain that, he puts in the work that is necessary to do that. He gives 100% to each and everything he does. Considering his level of success, it would be understandable if he had an ego as big as his biceps. But to be very honest with you, he has managed to be pretty humble. He believes that those struggles in the back of his mind help him to appreciate his success more. According to me, the journey of Rock has just started, and I believe in ensuing years he will be one of those living legends. And I would like to end this video by saying, we love you, Rock. Thank you guys for watching this video till now, and if you enjoyed it, make sure to share it with all those people who love Rock, aka Dwayne Johnson. And a huge shout out to Vedantrusty for doing this with us. I believe that he's going to be the next big thing on YouTube, mark my words. By the way, if you want to see more collaborations like this, make sure to support us by subscribing to this channel. Well, until the next video, see ya.